If you're one of those people that wants to create a more secure password profile for your online logins, but you don't trust password manager apps to keep all of your passwords safe, then the double-blind password strategy is for you. Simply put, the double-blind password is a means of creating and storing passwords in a password manager app that keeps the real password hidden from both the app and the user. In this video, I'm going to show you not only how it works, but we're going to walk through how to easily implement this strategy for your most sensitive online logins. Don't forget to subscribe to All Things Secured for more great online security tips, and let's go ahead and dive in. Okay, although the double-blind password strategy can be used on any password manager app software, for the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to be using 1Password, which is the one that I use. You can find links and further written instructions in the description below this video. Now let's look at exactly how the double-blind password strategy works. Pretend for a moment that this box right here is your password manager app. Now this app helps you to create strong passwords, and not only that, but it helps you to store those passwords behind a master password that only you know. Now, although these risks are very limited, there's the fear that someone might be able to get access to your master password and therefore have access to all of your most sensitive logins and data. So what if you were to take this strong password and you were to add a unique ID that only you know? In this case, you don't know your full password because you don't know, you can't remember exactly what the password manager created. But then again, whatever's stored here in the password manager app is not the full password. And the brilliance of this strategy is that you get the benefits of having a password manager app without the risks of putting all your eggs in one basket. Now, let's go ahead. I'm going to pull out my laptop and we're going to see exactly how this works in the real world. All right, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to log on to Facebook. I'm going to show you exactly how that would work. Using 1Password, it's going to come up and offer a suggestion for a login. I'm going to click that. The problem is if I try to log in with this password that it has stored, you're going to notice that it's actually a wrong password and Facebook is going to tell me as much. That is not a correct password. The password that you've entered is incorrect. So what I've actually done is this is a double-blind password. So I have to actually add the four, six, eight characters at the end of it that then make the password that the password manager app put in for me actually be correct. That is the double-blind password. So that's how a double-blind password works in practice. Now, how do you set it up? Let's do this again in Facebook, and I'm going to set up a new double-blind password. First, I'm going to go into my settings, and I'm going to click on my security and login. You can do this with your bank. You can do this with your email. I have it on all of my major problems or all my major logins. So I'm gonna click on changing password, and I've got my current password that it's gonna put in there. Now, I've already got a double blind password, so I've already gotta put that in. Now, I'm gonna have the password manager app create a new password. All right. And again, you're seeing me do this. Trust me when I say that I'm going to change this. I'm going to have it update in my password manager app. Okay. So it's updated in the password manager app, what it's put in there. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in my extra unique ID that makes this an even stronger password. Cause I don't know, I can't remember exactly what the password manager app put in there for me. All I know is my unique identifier. In the same way, the password manager app doesn't know my unique ID. And so I'm going to save those changes and I'm going to stay logged in for all of these. And again, what I'm doing is if I were to log out and I were to try to log back in using that password, the password that is stored in the password manager app is the wrong password. It has to have that unique identifier. And so that's what I'm going to add in, this unique identifier that then says, this is my correct password. And that's how you set it up. It's not that complicated, and I don't set it up for every single password I have. It's just for the most sensitive, my investments, my banking, my email, and some of my social media. What I love about this strategy is that your password is never stored anywhere, and yet you still have very strong, unique passwords for every single login that you have. That's all I've got for you. I hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up. If you have questions, leave a comment below. Thanks.